Let's begin by the word itself, artificial intelligence. There are two words inside, okay? Two keywords actually. The artificial. Artificial means, okay, in really it's not natural. It means it is not natural, okay? It's not real. Something which is not real, not natural. So what can it be? It can be a machine, okay? Because it is not real, not natural. So it can be machine, a computer, okay? Computer is also made by a human, a person. People made computer, people made the machine. That's why it is artificial, not real, okay? Also, we can think about robots, okay? They are also artificial, not real. So we are talking about in this course about all these, okay, elements. Robot, machine, computer, all these things. So that's why the whole word comes in, artificial, okay? Exactly, I should, honestly speaking, I think it should be something else, okay? But I will tell you later, it's okay. But for the time being, just think about artificial, which is not real, not natural. And that definitely comes into the machine, the robot, the computer. And intelligence means, okay, the second word means ability to learn something, to think something, to understand something, okay? So intelligence comes in, okay, from the child to a man, okay, like gradually, not completely, slowly, okay? If you are a child, you get the intelligence from your parents, okay? It is coming to you from the environment and it grows, okay, as you grow with the age, okay, that's all. So intelligence is the ability. You learn something in the childhood, but you are not proficient with, you're not so good, but later you get it, okay, much better way. And you think something as a child, not so good, but slowly you learn, you think much better than earlier, okay? Understand something slowly. So all these abilities of, okay, thinking and understanding is called intelligence. So we are growing our intelligence from the childhood to the young, okay, age. Even when we become more old, we get more intelligence. This is a common thinking, okay? That's okay. So why, okay, we have want to have artificial intelligence? I mean, the machine, okay? Let's say the machine which has ability to think, to understand, to learn, okay? All these things. Why we want to have a robot? Why we want to have a machine or computer to learn an ability to learn, think, understand? The reason is, okay, the reason is we want to make some decisions that we cannot do it, okay? We want to have a quick decision. We want to make a right decision if something is very complex. Usually a human can understand and make decisions for usual problems, but it cannot solve a big problem. For example, let's say if I have a millions of data, okay, millions of gigabyte of data or terabyte, okay, size data, millions of bytes of data, like terabyte or petabyte, okay, so it is hard for us to find something inside the data. It is hard for us to decide by getting that special data. So that's why we need artificial intelligence, the machine, the computers, the robot, okay, to find the best solution for us. So making decision is the ultimate goal for all those, okay, building of such kind of machine, thinking machine. Honestly speaking, I should say that the artificial intelligence should be thinking machine, okay? If I can, okay, thinking machine. What does it mean? It means A machine that can think something, okay, that can do something by thinking, just like a human, just like people. Okay, anyway, we will come to this topic later also again. That's okay. Let's move on. Okay, so there's a researcher, not a, actually in the history, but there was Alan Turing, okay, the first thinker, the first great, okay, scientist, mathematician, okay, who thought about such kind of machine. So there's a many web pages are also there about him, dedicated to him for his great works, okay, in the area of science and technology, and especially in the area of mathematics, okay. And he was a great thinker itself. Okay, also, okay, there's a web link where I put my, okay, one more interesting paper about, which is written by him. I will show you this paper because it seems to me very interesting to show you this paper, right? I will show you just for a moment, that's okay. It is like, if I can, just a second. This is actually a very interesting paper. That's why I want to share you with you, okay, all these things. Okay, so in his paper, the paper name was not this one, actually it was just the journal name, Minds and Machines, okay. Inside, he wrote the paper in around 1964 or somewhere else, around 1960s or something like this. Okay, but the main thing is, he wrote the paper with the title Computing Machinery and Intelligence. This was the first thought about thinking machine, okay? And it came from the question, he put a question first, can machine thinks, or can machines think, okay? If you want to make not just machine, machines, all the machines, okay? So can machines think? This was a question that he addressed in his paper, first time in the history. And he put forth an imitation game, okay? Imitation means making copy of a machine or just replicating, okay? Or just imitate, making a copy, making a fictitious, okay? Understanding of the machines, okay? This is a famous, okay, imitation game, or sometimes people say it, Turing test, okay, the same thing. And he put inside, okay, this imitation game, two components, actually. And he, I will show you later the experiments, but he put the imitation, the copy of machine, or just one side to the machine, and other side to a human, and asking question to both of them, the machine and the person. And the question was like this, okay? And he was recording the answers from them and asking again, and so many things happened. I will show you later. He put for the first time thinking machine, the keyword about artificial intelligence, okay? Also, okay, he discussed so many other things. I don't want to go because we don't have enough time this time. But the thing is, okay, he discussed about distant computers and so many other things. Okay, the main idea was also related to the discrete state machine. Okay, also, he did further his ideas about the machine itself. So it was the first paper he published with this new, okay, great idea. So it was a true innovation at that time, and it revolutionized AI, okay, that's all. So I will just, okay, go back to our slide, okay, let's move on. The thing is, I will just. So, Alan Turing was the first person who coined the word, thinking machine, thinking machine that became in the second word for the AI. So A goes to, sorry, not this one actually. A goes for this one and I goes for this one. Like this way. Anyway, let's move. This is some kind of interesting story that I want to share with you because these are some interesting points that will help you to understand the subject itself. Okay, that's all. So, what is artificial intelligence actually? So, people define from time to time what is artificial intelligence. And in the Turing paper, he also talked about artificial intelligence that it could be a science, it could be a science and engineering at the same time. So artificial intelligence is a science and engineering together. Science because we have to research in this area. What is artificial intelligence? What is going on? Why it is happening? Something like that. And engineering is in the case that if we want to build a machine, to make intelligent machine, this is the work that we can do with the engineering prospects. That's why it is called science and engineering. And especially to build a or make an intelligent machine. That's okay. So this is the first definition by John McCarthy. He also refined his ideas and put the definition of like this one. The another idea, another one is also of, we can think it as a task, a work, some kind of work of using computers, using a computer, to understand human intelligence. This is another definition. So it is a work using some computers to understand human intelligence. So this is another definition. The other definition is here. Don't get confused. There are many definitions for many people. The third one is like this one. It is the computational part, or just say computational. Computational. Entity computer computer. Can do it, computation, you know very well. Computational, in the sense that most of the time, the computation is done by the computers, and computations like a human cannot do, a big computation like working on 1 terabyte size of data or 1 petabyte size of data, like this. So it is hard for a human to find some interesting thing within such kind of big data. Anyway, the thing is, computational means part of, oh, sorry, I should say computational parts of the ability, to achieve goal. So artificial, actually intelligence, intelligence, not artificial intelligence. I just got to, this is AI, AI, and this is intelligence. So intelligence is can be in the humans, people, or animals. We will also see later, and also to other things. So we can have intelligence definition like this. Intelligence is computational part of the ability to achieve some goal. For example, I will share with you. Let's say a child do something, in the childhood. Let's say he is playing with some kind of computer game. A child who is playing a computer game, but he don't get succeed, he don't get succeed in the game, winning position. So this is his level of intelligence, because he is not so intelligent at that moment to do some such kind of computation to achieve a winning goal. But later, if he plays day by day and so on, finally he wins the game. Okay, so this is a computational part that plays the game and wins the game at the end. So this is one kind of intelligence he grows in his brain. Also, there are many examples actually. We will see later also again. So, the next thing is in the intelligence, I, if I say like I intelligence, then we can say that there are many types and many levels of intelligence. So for example, for example, I discuss about a child. So the childhood has low level of intelligence, in the beginning usually, but the level increases by the time, right? So there are many, many types of and many levels of intelligence, that happens in people, animals and machine. Here goes, so I was talking about, so in the humans, animals, or machine, even the machine can grow the intelligence if we put more, intelligence inside the machine. I will show you later, how to put the intelligence in the machine. The next thing is, so this is how, the level and the types of intelligence related to the people, animal and machine. So for the machine, let's say example, you have seen a machine which is working just for one purpose, For example, let's say in the workshop or in some factory, there are machines to make some products. Like, for example, if you want to make a product like milk product, the machine takes the milk and then process it, then they define it, then they pack it, making a good package, packaging, that's all, and finally it comes as product. So this is a one-way process. It does, maybe you can say there are several tasks, but the process is only one to make the product. So machines, single product, or single, outcome. It can have one, two, or three outcomes. Repeated operations. It will repeat the same process again and again. So this is one level of intelligence. If we can add more intelligence inside, so that the machine can do other things also, this will definitely increase the level of intelligence inside the machine. And we do it by the computer code programming inside the machine. This is all about this, level and the types of intelligence. Let's move on. So there are several levels and types of intelligence. Let's talk about human, or the people intelligence, natural intelligence, because we human have by birth, intelligence, we believe, as a child, thereafter, we have not artificial intelligence. No, not really. We have real intelligence, right? And the examples for natural intelligence is human, like us, animals do have, and plants also have, such kind of sensation, natural intelligence. I wish, for example, let's say the plants grows, from the roof, like this and this and this. And you might have seen some plants, gets infected by just like, some kind of virus, some kind of bacteria, from time to time, and it gets die, okay, because of these, okay, diseases problem. But some of the plants, okay, have capability to fight against such kind of bacteria and virus. So this is a natural intelligence. Also, okay, the nature gave them the power to grow in case of odd conditions. Let's say there's no water inside in the surroundings of the tree or plants. So without water, how they can grow? This is another kind of intelligence. So there are many, okay, kinds of, okay, botanical, okay, intelligence which are inside those plants. So that's why it is called in. It is also categorized as natural intelligence. Okay, so we can think about this one. That's also there. There was field of about such kind of, okay, intelligence in terms of their activity, okay, the plant's activity. Because if there's some kind of positive activity to grow without any obstacle, without any problem, that is another kind of intelligence. Anyway, let's move on. Okay, so, okay, intelligence, okay. So we are talking about the human intelligence, right? So in the case of human intelligence, intelligence, okay, is defined like this way, okay, all these. So first, let's say the capacity to learn and solve the problem. This is almost the same thing as I showed, told you. So intelligence means the capacity, the ability to learn and solve some problem, okay? This is the first thing. The ability to solve new problems, okay? This is also novel, new problems. This is also a type of intelligence, okay? Also, we have the intelligence means the ability to act rationally. This means, rationally, means we must have some rationale, okay, rational reasons, okay, to think about. We must have, okay, some thought, thinking with some reason that, okay, this is okay or this is not okay. If I do this, then it will happen like this. If I don't do this one, it will not be like this, or it will be other way, else it will be like this way. Okay, the reason, if else, maybe also if else, okay, this is the first way of thinking, or maybe yes, no, this is also rational. And so rationality, reason, okay, thinking with reason. In short, thinking with reason, with logic, that, okay, true or false, okay, this is true or false. So such kind of ability is also a kind of intelligence. Okay, ability to act like human, this is very common, okay? So we were talking about the computers, okay, and computers to understand human intelligence. So this is, okay, also a part of intelligence. We want to put the intelligence, human intelligence, inside the machine, inside the computer. Our intelligence, how we think, how we solve the problems, we want to put inside the computers, okay? So that, okay, the computers may think and do the same thing as we do, okay? This is the main objective, to make a decision, okay? Okay, anyway, let's move to the next one, intelligence, okay, intelligence. It is again repeated so many times, that's so weird. But, okay, the ability to learn or understand, okay, intelligence means, okay, and to deal with, okay, new or existing problems, situations, okay, The ability to apply your knowledge, to work, okay, skillfully in some environment, in some situation, circumstances. The ability, okay, to think in general way, generic way, or abstract way, okay, and it is measured by some measurement factors, okay, measured by some objective criteria that like there's a test and you have ability to think about the test and solving the problem in general way, not in very difficult manner, but rather you see a question inside the test. Let's say in the test you see the question and you read the question just like in a common way, very careful but common way, okay, about the what is the question, okay, then you solve the problem, okay, the answer is like this, okay, and you, so this is also a kind of intelligence, your ability to think in very general way, don't go so, okay, complex, so difficult, just in very common sense, okay, common way, general way, generic way, okay, to, and then try to solve the problem, that's all. So this is another, okay, way of thinking about the intelligence. Anyway, let's move to the next one. Programming, okay, these are the definition of AI, okay, so programming human intelligence inside the computer or the machine, right? Also, AI tries to simulate and make, okay, making, okay, the process, okay, exactly the same way as human intelligence, okay? So AI tries to make the exactly the same process inside the machine, our intelligence, human intelligence, that's all. And it is convenient to use computers, okay? These days we have computers, so we find it is easier to work with the computer to put the intelligence, in human intelligence, inside those machines, okay? Also, artificial intelligence is a branch of computer science and having technological parts itself, okay? And it studies about, okay, the development of intelligent machines and even the softwares also, because softwares are used to run such kind of hardware or the machine, okay? So softwares are also important component. So there are four important features, okay? Four important factors, okay, about the AI. Number one, it thinks, okay, thinking capability. So what does it mean? It means that AI, okay, must have, okay, artificial intelligence, the machines must have think ability, okay? It is almost the same thing, okay, as we discussed earlier. It is repeated many times. So just take it easy, okay? Think ability, okay? Ability to think about reasoning, okay? Why we want to do this, not that, why it is yes, not no, why, okay? So all the, okay, questions of reason, there should be some reason, okay, reasoning. So reasoning is based on logic. If I do this, then it will happen like this, as it will happen like this, okay? So these are reasoning. So we do it usually in the machines by programming, okay? That's why programming or software developments are important factor in building such kind of machines. But the thing is, reasoning, okay, is another component. The third component is behavior. Behavior like doing something in response to something. So for example, if you do something, you get some response. That is behavior. So in the same way, we study the behavior, and do or implement all those things inside the machine. This is another feature of AI. So this is an important factor, behavior. Performance, number four, is your efficiency to do something, your activity, measurement. And usually it is in number. That suppose you run in some race, your running speed is so quick, you finish 100 meter race in, let's say, in 5 seconds, but the another one, your friend has completed it in 4 seconds, then his efficiency is more, performance is more than you. So this is based on speed. Sometimes the quality is another factor to ensure the performance of something. So quality is, I should write, is also a very essential factor in measuring the performance. Let's move to the next section. So the next thing is properties. Properties. So the properties of intelligence. So some of the major factors are like this. Number one, the ability to collect skillful knowledge. So our brain saves some useful knowledge for us. Why? Because it want to keep that knowledge for our future problems. This is our ability as a human. In the same way, as per the intelligence, this is an ability, to collect skillful knowledge. Also natural language understanding. So we can understand, if you speak Arabic and this is natural language, so you can, your friend can understand. This is understanding of natural languages, but how the machine can understand you? So there should be, some translator. So we study, all these things inside AI, and especially to make such kind of intelligent machines, putting intelligence inside the machine. We will come to this topic later. That's okay. General problem solving. We must have general problem solving to categorize as intelligence. Also perception is another factor. Another property. We can say property, another property. So these are the properties, 1, 2, 3, 4 properties, the perception, number one, this one. So perception, what is perception? Perception is some kind of sense or notice, or thinking, or understanding from something else. For example, let's say if you see a portrait of some sceneries, like mountains and the trees itself, and also some river or the lake inside, and you are watching from here, like this way, and you see it, you get some kind of sensation, understanding, some kind of thinking that yes, this is a very beautiful mountain, and this lake is very cool. All these things. So this is called sensation. You notice the scenery and observe a lot of ideas, behind the scenery. Sensation, you notice something, you think something, you understand all the scene, each and every part of that one. So this is called perception altogether. Means to get, thinking to get the sense of the object. So this you can think it out, this is object where you look at, right? So perception is the ability, your ability to sense, notice, think, understand from consciousness. If you are conscious, you are very keen, very attentive, okay? And you have feelings, you have interests, then you will get perception, okay? Otherwise, it will not be in your brain. So if you have serious, okay, seriousness, attention, feeling, interest, then you will get all those ideas, okay? So this is perception, actually, right? Okay, let's move to the next one, inference or deduction. So by, okay, having such kind of property, we can get final conclusion, result, natija, okay? That, okay, this is very beautiful, this is not so good, okay, like this. So this is also inference and deduction. You deduce, you get the idea, right? Okay, let's move to the next one. The next one is, we may have, okay, several goals, mainly, especially two goals in AI, long-term and short-term. The long-term is putting more and more intelligence inside the machine. This is our long-term goal. Let the computer be intelligent with time, more and more intelligent, okay? With putting more programming inside the machine or something, okay? Short-term means just working condition. You did it with the minimum intelligence and the machine is working with the least or minimum task, okay? Just one task, doing only one thing, two things, that's all. Not more than one thing or two things, okay? So this is a short-term goal. This is a quick one, this is a long one, okay? So this is all about the computer to make easier to work with, okay? This one, short-term, right? So, okay, the advantages of AI. Okay, so the main advantage are it can solve, okay, new problems, okay? Also, it can help the people in their work, in their lives, okay? And you will see a lot of AI activities, applications are going on day by day. It is increasing in our life. Increase efficiency, okay, of the computers, increase the speed of the computers, save, okay, computer storage by running, storing, okay, all those small programs. Okay, this one I talked about earlier, okay, Turing test, or this is also called act humanly, yani act like a human, the machine, okay. So in this test, a person, okay, interrogator, asking so many questions to the machine and the person, human, okay? And he gets the answer all the time, back and forth, okay? And this is how he decides whether the machine is intelligent or not, okay? So that's why it is called Turing test, to test, to check, to verify, okay? To verify for the level or for the intelligence, okay? Right? So the test of the machine's ability. So this is Turing test. Turing test is a test of a machine's ability, okay? Ability to demonstrate intelligence. How much the machine is intelligent. This is the measurement, okay? Test, Turing test. Operational, okay? Test for intelligent behavior, okay? Imitation game, as I have shown you earlier. So this is not so difficult, just testing for intelligence. Okay, let's move to the next one. There are four categories of AI. The same thing, actually. Act, okay, like human. Think like human. Think like rational. Rational, I have already defined what is rational, okay? So the logical thinking, okay, is rational. Also, act like rational. Okay, rational. So see here, act. So act like human, act like rational, think like human, think like rational. So this is okay, how we categorize. And the same thing is here, okay? System that think like human, system that think like rational, so think rationally, okay? A system that act like human, system act like rationally, okay? These are all. And these are some other definition. If you wish for, you can go through it, all these, okay? That's all. In the AI, okay, it is, you can think it is a thinking machine, a machine that can think, okay? Building such machines, okay, needs clone or copy or the same, exactly the same, okay, human thinking, human brain, okay, human cognition, cognitive activity. So to make such kind of machine, we should know first how the brain, our brain, human brain works, then we can make the same machine, is it? So that's why we study the human brain, that is called cognitive science, okay? The science of mind, human mind, okay? Mainly, and to get the idea of human brain, human mind, we study the human brain, okay? Using functional magnetic resonance, okay? Imaging process. So what's going on in your brain, it is observed by scanning through fMRI, right? Some parts of the brain gets activated at some moment, okay? Others don't, okay? So these are all, okay, indication of what's going on in your mind. Which part is active? This means you are thinking about something, not the other thing, okay? And we scientists, okay, psychological, okay, specialist or the neuroscientists can understand your behavior by observing such kind of, okay, scanning. So brain imaging is the process. Okay, let's move to the next one. So AI thinking, okay? AI thinking, okay? Think, okay, rationally. Or thinking rational, okay? The same thing is repeated many times. Okay. So this is the history. Socrates was the teacher of the Aristotle, and he started the word thinking, thoughts, okay? He had many thoughts. So he discovered that the laws of thoughts are like, it should be logical and there should be some difficulties to get the logic. If it is a very, very simple, okay, then there is no logic, then perhaps it is not a good thought, okay? Okay, expressing knowledge, okay, as logical formula, okay, is another thinking, okay? Okay, wait for 5 minutes, that's okay, I will finish. So these are the foundation of AI. AI is not a single, okay, subject. It is interdisciplinary, means it is connected with many other areas like philosophy, mathematics, economics, neuroscience, psychology, okay, control theory, linguistics, computer engineering, computer science, so on. So the history of AI is very big, and I will not go through this complete history, okay? You can see it. And a thinking machine was the first idea by the Turing, and from there, the birth of AI, early enthusiasm, okay? Great expectations, and so on. So it happened from time to time, see? A timeline. So you can study all this history if you wish for. 60s and then 70s and then 80s and 90s and so on, 2000. But final, okay, stage is here. We are moving from 2010 to 2020 and 20 furthermore, and there are new branches are emerging from time to time. Now we have quantum AI and extended, okay, very advanced level artificial intelligence, quantum AI, quantum artificial intelligence. Or we have many applications of AI, okay, in GPS, general problem solving, expert system, robotics, okay. Also NLP, natural language processing, game playing, okay, machine, okay, learning systems, right? Artificial neural networks, intelligent agents, okay, and also we have also applications in the area of pattern recognition. All these kinds of patterns, okay, are there. Okay? Also, we have speech recognition. Okay, now it is very famous day by day, and autonomous, okay, planning and scheduling, which is very famous in space explorations, right? Robotic vehicle, okay, robot vehicles are very interesting part in itself. Using AI, this is application. Also, the application you can find in the spam fighting, okay, logistic planning, all these, okay. So you should study all these things in short if you wish for. Robotics and machine transition translations, okay, right. So all these are applications. So far we didn't get enough, okay. We still have to, okay, get more and more, okay, advancements in AI. But up to now we got all these, okay, achievements, not completely but partially, okay, in the area of robotics, speech recognition, planning and scheduling, game playing, spam filtering, machine translation, big data, and so on. So these are all about the AI. So we finished our chapter one, okay, by this time. And the summary is, AI is the science and engineering of building intelligent machines, okay, so that can understand, okay, us humans, okay, machines that act like rational, okay, like rational. So there should be some rationale about, okay, all these, okay, activity which is inside the machine. This is our purpose, to make such kind of machine. So there's a rich history, okay, impressive achievement up to now, and a great future for us to work in this area, promising, challenging, okay, very tough, okay, job ahead. So this is all about, okay, AI.